It's so great to see you today. I'm glad you're here at Beach Kids Online because we're finding out how we can stand and face our fears with courage. Courage is being brave enough to do what you should do even when you are afraid. That is right, friends. Even when you're afraid, we want to have courage. Sometimes we might face things in life that can seem pretty big and scary. We might find ourselves in situations where we're not sure, where we kind of know what we're supposed to do, but we're not sure we have the guts to actually do it. The great news is that we don't have to face those things alone. We know for sure that God is with us. God can give us the courage to stand tall and do what we know is right. I am so thankful that we can trust God no matter what. God has the power to do anything. As Jesus himself said, all things are possible with God. How great is that, to have that promise from God? I think that is something to celebrate. Let's sing to Jesus and thank him for making us brave.
I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody.
doesn't it feel so good when we take time to sing to God? I love that we can be brave and worship God with courage and confidence. In the book of Psalms, King David wrote, "Lord, I will give you thanks with all of my heart. I will tell about all the wonderful things you have done." Friends, worship is a great way that we show our thanks to God. Since we've already sang some worship songs to God, I thought that we could hear a true story from the Bible about another person that had the courage and trusted in God. Let's check out who it is today.
Welcome to Story Lab. This week, we're talking about courage while we take a look at the story of someone who faced a pretty dark night. Oh, and don't miss this.
I'm Amaya.
And I'm Zeke.
And we're talking about courage.
That's being brave enough to do what you should do, even when you're afraid.
Even when something unexpected happens.
Unexpected?
How do you feel about the dark?
A little nervous. I mean, I can't see. Can we please have the lights back? Hey!
Lots of people don't like the dark. So I thought we could try something to make dark fun.
Oh, laser tag.
Pew, 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 pew.
Or something kids can try at home.
Flashlight tag.
Pew, pew, pew.
Or go in the dark slime.
Oh, I've never made slime.
Me neither.
Alrighty then, let's make it. Okay, what do we use for this experiment?
Oh, right. So we have clear school glue, water, baking soda, and glow powder. First, we put in the glue. Perfect. Next, we add the water. Baking soda. And finally, we add the glow powder. So pretty. And now we stir. And make sure you stir really good. Come on, Zeke, put some muscle in it.
That is not slime.
Not yet, because we still need slime activator.
Saline, my mom uses that to clean her contact lenses.
It contains borate ions.
Glue is made of long chains of molecules called polymers that slide easily past each other. When borate ions are added, they cross-link the protein molecules in the glue so they can no longer slide easily past each other.
So borate ions glue the glue?
Pretty much.
Cool. Let's see what happens. Slime, activate!
All right, I'll pour it, you stir.
Oh, I can already feel it hardening. So disgusting and weirdly satisfying.
I know, right?
Get the lights. Whoa.
Look at it glow. That is so cool.
Oh.
I want some.
It's all slimy.
Oh. So cool.
Oh, it's everywhere. Snot in my hands. Ugh.
I'm getting all of it. No.
Woo!
Ah!
Okay, the dark can be pretty fun.
Yes, unless you're joined in the dark by extra big, hungry cats.
Is that a spoiler?
Yes, it's time for
the story before the story.
Today, we're in book 27 of the Old Testament, Daniel.
God had promised to bless the whole world through Abraham's family, the Israelites. God delivered them from slavery and led them to freedom in the land of Canaan.
God gave the Israelites kings to lead them. But while some kings like David listened to God, many of the kings ignored God.
These kings even led the people to worship false gods. And at last, God allowed the Israelites to be conquered by foreign nations.
Yeah, some of the Israelites were even marched off as captives to Babylon.
But one of these captives, a man named Daniel, still loved God and prayed to God every day. And Daniel is a hero of today's story.
Let's go!
Daniel was taken to Babylon as a young man, but even as a captive, he still stood up for the one true God.
We won't make ourselves unclean by eating the king's food. Test us for 10 days. Give us only vegetables to eat.
God blessed Daniel and made him strong and wise. That wisdom and courage gained Daniel a lot of respect, and he actually served as an advisor to several foreign kings over his lifetime. One of them was King Darius, who conquered Babylon. Now, when King Darius took charge, he placed 120 officials over the whole kingdom and put three governors over them. One of these three men was Daniel. Daniel was so trustworthy and did such a good job that Darius actually made plans to put Daniel in charge of the other two governors. So when these other two rulers found out about the plan, they were pretty angry. They decided to find something wrong with Daniel they could tell the king about. But even though they spied on Daniel, they couldn't find a thing he'd done wrong.
Not one single lie!
But Daniel does have this thing about praying to his God.
3 times a day like clockwork!
The jealous governors and officials perfected a sneaky plan and took it to King Darius.
King Darius, may you live forever!
You're so incredibly amazing. We think you should make a special command.
What is it?
For the next 30 days, no one in the whole kingdom can pray to anyone but you.
I like it.
And if they pray to someone else, they get thrown into a lion's den.
Where do I sign?
Well, King Darius was so flattered that he gave orders for the law to be written down, and he signed it at once. And you have to know this. Once a law of the Medes and Persians was written down, it could not be changed, even by the king himself. When Daniel found out about the law, it would have been easy enough to change his routine and stop going home to pray every day. But Daniel's love for God was greater than his fear of lions. The next morning, as every morning, Daniel knelt in his room and prayed to God.
Thank you that you are always with me, God. Help me honor you in everything I do.
Daniel went to his room to pray again at noon and in the evening, even though he probably knew the other officials were watching him. And sure enough, they were delighted to find Daniel disobeying the king's law. They rushed off to the king as fast as they could.
King Darius, didn't you sign an order that for 30 days no one can pray to anyone but you?
I did. Or they'd be thrown into a lion's den. No one would risk it.
Except Daniel!
He still prays to his God 3 times every day.
When Darius realized he'd been trapped, he was very upset. He didn't want Daniel to be harmed, but even he couldn't find a way around the law. So at sunset, the king called for Daniel to be brought out and thrown in the lion's den.
Daniel, you always serve your God faithfully, so may he save you.
Then Daniel was shoved into the dark den, and a stone was placed over the entrance. Now, we don't know exactly what Daniel felt alone in that deep, dark place with prowling lions. But in the palace, the king was so sick with fear he couldn't sleep. As soon as the sun rose, he hurried back to the lion's den.
Daniel, you serve the living God. Has he been able to save you from the lion?
Morning sunlight revealed Daniel, with the powerful lions curled up around him, tame as house cats.
My God sent his angel to to shut the mouths of the lions. They haven't hurt me at all.
Oh, lift him out of the den at once.
Daniel was completely unharmed. The king was so amazed that he wrote a letter to everyone in the kingdom.
I order people in every part of my kingdom to respect and honor Daniel's God. He is the living God. He has saved Daniel from the power of the lions.
Daniel continued to serve the king. And because of Daniel's courage, every person in the land heard about the one true God. The end.
A whole den full of lions. Daniel must have been so scared.
Oh, for sure. But he could look back on the times that God had helped him. He trusted God to be with him no matter what.
So, what's our part in the story?
Well, okay, maybe your mom told you to take the trash to the curb hours ago, but you forgot and now it's dark. It might be tempting to just skip it, but you can trust God to be with you while you do it.
Or maybe you have to give a book report in front of the whole class, and it's your first time, so you're super nervous.
It would be easy to just tell the teacher you lost your voice and can't quite do it.
Yeah, but truth is, you can trust that God is with you, even in front of the class.
Yeah, God knows we all struggle with fear sometimes. That's one of the reasons God gave us Jesus. When we believe in Jesus and follow him, we have God's Spirit to help us face anything that comes our way, from a book report to a barking dog to a mean kid.
I think we've got it.
Thank you, Brian.
See you next time.
So here's the thing. You can do what you should because God is with you.
Too bad Daniel didn't have this stuff to glow in the lion's den.
Yeah, I don't think you can ever get that out of big cat fur.
I don't think I'm ever gonna get it off my hands.
Thanks for joining us in the Story Lab. See you next time.
Daniel was in a sticky situation in the lion's den, but he trusted that God was with him. Daniel knew something that we should remember too. He knew that he could trust God no matter what. God is with each of us, no matter what challenges and scary situations we might have to face in life. Today, our bottom line is this. You can do what you should because God is with you. Can you say that with me? Repeat after me. You can do what you should because God is with you. I remember when there was a time when my parents were getting divorced and I was really scared of what my life was gonna look like. But I knew that God was with me and I could face my fears and that my family would be okay. God was with me then and I know God is with me today. And God is with you too. Don't forget that when you believe in Jesus and follow him, you have God's Spirit to help you face anything that comes your way. You can do what you should because God is with you. Let's talk to God about that right now. I'm gonna close my eyes, bow my head as I talk to God. We call it praying. Dear God, thank you for the story of Daniel in the lion's den and for bringing him through that scary situation. We know that Daniel was able to stay strong because you were right there with him. We know that you're here with us too, and we are so thankful. Help us to have the courage, no matter what we face in life, because you're there to help us. We love you, God, and we pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, friends. I'll see you next time. Have so much fun doing your Beach Kids online activities.
Goodbye, my friend. Goodbye. We gotta go, but we'll see you again. Goodbye, my friend. Goodbye. It's time to go. Can't wait to see you again.
Friend. we'll see you again.
Come on.
Goodbye.